now, if it isn't two of my dearest friends. As for the other two, I don't believe we've had the pleasure.
Not in this vessel, perhaps. Tis I, Vashan. Though, you are welcome to call me Vritra, if you prefer.
Pay me no mind. I merely accompany them.
I pray you forgive us our intrusion. If you are occupied, we shall call again anon.
It's quite all right. We've just finished swapping all our secrets anyway. Erenfil occasionally comes and shares the latest gleaner gossip, you see. From forgotten ruins to mysterious relics, if there's aught that might be of interest to the students, he kindly lets us know.
Alas, I must soon depart on an expedition. As I may be away for an extended period, I wish to give Kryl fair warning, hence my visit today.
I see. There are specimens that want for procuring, I presume?
No, it isn't guildship business, but rather... homecoming. But enough about me. You have business too, yes? And I'm in the way.
Far from it. As a matter of fact, we should be grateful if you could stay and share your knowledge of the nearby isles with us. We seek a means to travel to the void. There, a man named Golbez plots to invade our world. A man who even now holds my sister hostage. To that end, we require a great quantity of ether, which we understand may be had on the Isle of Haam. We came in the hope of exploring how it might best be procured.
An invasion from the 13th? Must the stakes always be so dramatic?
You have a knack for finding trouble. If gleaners collected world-ending crises, you could make quite a name for yourself in our profession. It's true the Isle of Haam is a veritable font of ether, but as it's under the Forum's direct jurisdiction, only a privileged few get to set foot there. I myself haven't.
So if we want to help ourselves to the Isle's ether, we'll need to secure the Forum's permission. Very well. The students of Baldessian recognize your endeavors as combating a grave threat to the world. As representative, I hereby pledge our full assistance. Now that it's official, you may leave the politics and paperwork to me. Our operations remain small, but we shouldn't meet any undue resistance.
We are truly grateful.
If I may. According to the original plan for the Exodus, ether collected from the Isle of Haam was to power the Ark. Art thou perchance familiar with the logistics of this endeavor?
I don't know anything about that, I'm afraid. Nor do I think any gleaner would. You might have better luck asking someone involved with the Ark's construction. Margaret, for instance. She's a researcher in Charlie and Hamlet. I met with her for a job recently, and she mentioned working on the Ragnarok's propulsion system. You could do worse than to seek her out while awaiting the Foreign's verdict.
We may well do just that. Our gratitude for thine advice, and may this threat be but a memory upon thy return.
You're quite welcome. Now then, if you'll excuse me.
I best start drafting our petition. Go on and find your researcher. I'll contact you as soon as we've made progress.
Let us leave matters here to Mistress Kryle and hie ourselves to Labyrinthos.
Right then, time to put our best foot forward. Oh, a pity you can't tidy yourself. I should have had Ishtola enchant you when I had the chance. And what have we here? Later, Kryle, later. You've work to do.
Bound for the Isle of Haam. You look like the ones Master Fortuno told me to expect. If you're ready to depart, and so am I. Just say the word.
Is something the matter?
I did recruit one other to our party, but he is late to arrive. Forgive me my delay.
Tancred, 'tis good to see you.
If it isn't Varshan, they do grow up so quickly. Urianje tells me we have a host of exciting new tribulations to face. And you must be Zero. I've heard all about your derring do in Garlemald. A pleasure.
Apart from strengthening our company with his redoubtable skill at arms, Tancred may also serve as a mentor in those matters that trouble thee. I speak of the intangible forces which bring souls together. Tancred is possessed of experience both unique and insightful that I am sure he would gladly share with thee. Thou needst but ask.
my way!
Darkness, take you!
Out of my way!
My turn.
Thank you. out of my way! Out of my way!
That's far enough!
Thank you. You're mine!
You forced my hand.
This will hurt.
Thank you.
mercy! You forced my hand!
Thank you.
Haam of the first human!
We'll be right back. Much obliged for clearing the way. We'll get to work at once. Filling these up will take a good while. I appreciate it if you stood watch till we finished. I ain't getting chewed to chum by some ether-bloated bugger. Oh, by the by! Where were you planning on putting these to use?
We could deliver them by airship, see? Provided it ain't too far.
We would need them transported to Galim, to the Tower of Babel.
Ah, that's a long old journey. Too long for a direct flight. Tell you what, we'll send them over with the scheduled shipment of provisions headed that way. I'll make the arrangements as soon as we get back. Save some poor chocobos having to drag this lot through the snow.
You have our thanks. We shall not forget your generosity.
Everything seems to be proceeding apace. I dare say he would have been fine without me.
Why would you say such a thing? You are not bound by contract or the threat of force, and you gain no advantage by devaluing your own contribution. Yet you must be bound by something to speak thus. What is it?
What binds me? A belief, I suppose. Born of our shared struggles. No matter where my comrades go, I have faith they will be fine. For I know that they will walk their chosen path as surely as I walk mine. I trust them, in short. Trite though it may sound.
Trust. I remember the word. How long has it been since last I used it? It had no place in my dealings. Not with other voids and certainly not with Xenos. Not even in the time before darkness engulfed the world. Full often did Memoriates betray their own, corrupted by the very power they wielded. You could trust no one but yourself. Alone we fought, and alone we fell. I wouldn't know how to trust. Is there some trick to it?
Just stay close to this one. You'll learn in no time. Absolutely fine.
I confess I thought thou mightst have more words of counsel to offer.
Oh, she'll soon get the hang of it, even without my help. After our work here is done, I'll see myself back to the shadows. But before that, I take it you've heard as well.
Indeed. The client seeketh Archons, and 'twould seem our extensive travels and neutrality make us prime candidates.
Well, assuming we take on the request, I suspect I'll be stuck with you again. Don't let me down,